Newsham Park Hospital in Liverpool, England is known worldwide as the site of an extremely dark and negative haunting. Karina and I have been researching this building for years, both anticipating and dreading the chance to someday step inside and experience it for ourselves. Originally built in 1874 as the Royal Liverpool Seamen's Orphanage, it held the orphans of the city's many sailors lost at sea. Over the next 75 years, life was tough for the thousands of children there, with siblings routinely separated and cruel punishments for those that didn't follow the strict rules. Hundreds of children died there, many never knowing another home. It became a hospital in 1954, then a psychiatric asylum in 1992. During this time, it held some of the country's criminally insane, including the horrific serial killer Ian Brady, convicted of torturing and murdering five children in the 1960s. Now, as the 99,000 square foot building sits abandoned, it has reportedly become a well-known sanctum for restless spirits. Shadow figures, phantom apparitions, and disembodied voices are a regular occurrence, and some former employees simply refuse to return.
My name is John Craig, and I started work at Park Hospital in 1973, and I was glad to leave that place. It is most haunted and evil.
Now, after hearing years of reports from the former orphanage in Newsham Park, Karina and I will finally spend 72 hours investigating the dark haunting here to determine what makes Newsham Park Hospital one of the United Kingdom's most notoriously haunted locations.
It's night two. We had a lot of paranormal activity so far, but we haven't had any negative activity that people have talked about. Many people believe that the basement is the heart of this negative entity here. We're gonna go there right now to see if we can find this thing and document the activity.
Oh shit, okay. We're in the laundry room and I notice there's this table that's been made into a homemade spirit board. Automatically, this sends off some red flags for me. A lot of times when people make spirit communication, they don't always take the precautions that they should. These homemade spirit boards are made out of tables that are original to this building. So already these tables are holding a lot of different types of energy, probably very emotional energy. So the fact that they're making spirit boards out of that could potentially make whatever they're inviting in even worse.
Feeling weird all of a sudden.
Like what?
I don't know, like something's right here with us. I say we set up a big experiment. We're gonna set up experiments in the basement so we can try to find this negative presence. This experiment is totally different than anything else we've done. We have a hazer, which is gonna fill this room with a little bit of fog because we wanna have these lasers shooting right through them to indicate if there's any shadow figures, any breaks of the beam. Mm-hmm. So I think with this experiment, hopefully we'll be able to see everything that Paul's talked about. I'm really curious to see if we can pick up on any of this energy.
And also confirm whether or not it's negative.
We have the motion-activated light panels set up on the ground.
We also have a digital camera that sees really well in low light. We're gonna set it up on a tripod. It will take automatic photos every 5 seconds. So this way, if any mass or figure shows up within the fog and the lasers, we'll have photographic evidence to analyze it.
Whoa, I see something like forming out of the haze. Is the camera still snapping?
Yeah, it is. I'm just checking it to see if anything shows up.
I lost my head. It just goes, I lost my head. Paul talked about seeing a solid figure. Are we actually documenting this negative presence that people have been talking about? What happened? Did you get in an accident? Was your head cut off by an accident that happened down here?
Whoa.
See, look, did you see that?
I saw that.
And do you think we have it on camera? Yeah, we do.
I mean, we'll definitely have it on our cameras.
This is awesome. Let's keep talking to them.
As we're asking questions, these light panels just light up so distinctly that it's undeniable that this is an intelligent communication coming through.
That was you? Am I talking to this person who lost their head? Whoa, right there.
I saw it. How did you lose your head?
Sod?
Sod?
It said sod. It was sawed off?
Someone sawed off your head?
Can you tell us what your name is? Sid.
Sid came through again?
That was really clear.
Sid?
So we have a name. His name's Sid. Communicate with us.
Sid, if this is you who we're talking to, do me a favor. Every time the answer to a question is yes, make all those lights light up really bright like you've been doing.
Were you brought here? Were you one of the mental patients?
Ooh, yeah. Oh. So do you think it was mental? You just started to ask that question and it went off.
You were brought here? Were you a patient here? Whoa.
Okay. So yes,
wow.
Yes to a patient.
Yes, I was a patient.
Okay.
I think it's referring to something happened because it said saw too.
Right.
So maybe they sawed his head off.
Oh, like an accident?
Or during an autopsy, an accident, something happened here. Did you follow your body down here to the freezer? That went off,
yeah.
Right? Were you murdered? Did someone hurt you with a saw?
Sid, where'd you go?
This is so weird and just like went away for a second. That was really strong communication to something that was extremely intelligent. I swear at one point in the haze, I saw something for me.
I think we both thought we were seeing the same thing.
Right?
It's like towards this corner. To me, it looked like it was almost like this like round ball that started forming.
Exactly.